This is Dr. Katherine Bankole-Medina, and in today's podcast, I would like to share thoughts surrounding the field of digital history, taken from a recent lecture entitled Hallowed Grounds, Sites of African American Memories, Preserving Our History. Now, this particular discussion explores historians, the digital history revolution, and the quest for immortality. I want to thank Dr. Larry Martin, Professor of History at Coppin State University, for convening this panel for the Department of Humanities, the History Program, and the African American History Month Committee here at the university. As you know, this panel is an important part of the History Program's annual Carter G. Woodson Lecture in commemoration of Black History Month. And I will ask Dr. Martin to correct my understanding, because I would surmise that the Woodson program has taken place annually here at Coppin for more than 30 years?
Close to 20.
I thought it was something like that. So it has a long-standing tradition here. I want to state from the outset that I defer to the expertise of my colleagues on today's subject, which broadly addresses technology and preserving the past. Ms. Fisher of the African American Department, State Library Resource Center of the Enoch Pratt Library, who you just heard, and Dr. Matthews, who heads the Digital Production Center at Howard University. My brief comments will focus on historians, the digital history revolution, and the quest for immortality. I would like to begin with a recent anecdote that illustrates much of my point. Last week, one of my students asked me what a card catalog was. You have to understand that the question struck me in much the same manner as a thunderbolt would have. First of all, I had never been asked that question before. And second, I was amazed at just how versed I was in the history of the card catalog system. In the process of discussing this with the students, it proved to be a great opportunity to dialogue about our technology, how our technology specifically has changed, and how these changes have revolutionized historical knowledge and information. So, what is the role of historians in the digital revolution, and why is it a quest for immortality? Historians contribute to how the field is shaped. So, as we ask the question, what is digital history? We are also in the process of defining what it is. For those who are looking for a useful definition, there are many. And to be sure, digital history is more than putting materials online. Here is one definition from the authors C. Felt and Thomas, published in the American Historical Association. And I'm just going to give you a very brief synopsis of their definition of digital history. Digital history might be understood broadly as an approach to examining and presenting the past that works with the new communication technologies of the computer, the internet, network, and software systems. On one level, digital history is an open arena of scholarly production and communication, encompassing the development of new course materials and scholarly data collection efforts. On another level, digital history is a methodological approach framed by the hypertextual power of these technologies to make, define, query, and annotate associations in the human record of the past. So to do digital history is to digitize the past, but it is much more than that. It is to create a framework through the technology for people to experience, read, and follow an argument about a major historical problem. So for our purposes, this is a good starting point for looking at digital history and why the historian is so important. So I would like to offer a few considerations here. We can begin by understanding that digital history is a huge area filled with vigorous activity. There is furious scholarly debate about what actually constitutes digital history and how it will challenge us and transform our lives. I might add that while some universities are attempting to eliminate the discipline of history altogether, many other institutions of higher learning are enhancing history academic programs and embracing their function in the digital age. What we have discovered thus far is that historians have important responsibilities in the digital revolution. Their part is not greater than the digital archivist, the curator, or librarian, but their role is essential as the discipline of history grows with the technology. For example, in the digital revolution, historians have the ability to teach students new ways of studying and researching the past. We are learning innovative ways of discovering useful historical information. Historians are important collaborators in terms of digital projects. Historians can develop collective digital history projects, and this includes collaborations with faculty as well as students. For example, I would like to engage our students in the development of a digital history library that supports the learning of historical knowledge, makes a contribution to the university. Projects like this engage students intellectually, train them, and teach them team building skills, as well as scholarly collaboration. Digital historians must explain how knowledge acquisition has changed over time. Now, it has been thousands of years since humans have used papyrus and cuneiform tablets to write down information. We now use electronic tablets, e-readers, and digital pens, along with a host of other electronic reading, writing, and recording tools. Understanding how we have acquired historical knowledge tells us about the development of world societies, how we actually engage technology, and even something about our shared knowledge of humanity. Now, I'd like to move to the way historians think about how historical knowledge is constructed and delivered. We can read about Harriet Tubman and Frederick Douglass's fight to free themselves and other African people, but how will we think differently about their self-emancipation efforts when we engage their experience as we more visually view their information through interactive and hypertext modes, which also uses maps showing us their journeys? And as we do this, are we able to do so with open access, open source efforts? And most of you know I'm a big proponent of open access, open source, free textbooks, free knowledge, free information. Just as the history professor instructs students about how to interrogate internal and external print material, he or she must demonstrate how students evaluate websites and other cyber sources in order to determine the validity of digitized documents. Authentication of documents is becoming an immense issue, which includes establishing digital provenance and historical forensics. In 2012, authors Burdick, Drucker, and Lunenfeld, and others took a critical look at the trajectory of digital humanities in an effort to help us understand that humanities as a discipline is changing rapidly, but is not diminished. To understand digital history and humanities means that we need new thinking about the disciplines and the subject fields. What is the importance of text-based versus digital-based historical scholarship, and how do they complement one another? As a professor of history, I am always concerned about how technology enhances instruction, particularly our use of digital primary and secondary source materials, and I always want to know how I can effectively channel historical knowledge and information to students using the latest technologies. Then there is the issue of the historian as a custodian of the past. The historian has no choice but to become a curator, a preserver of knowledge and information, a professional caretaker of historical knowledge. This means we are concerned with the preservation of knowledge as well as the delivery systems used to impart this knowledge. Now, none of this means that our libraries, our archives, our research centers are over. And as I've stated before, I always defer to the expertise of their leadership. But in terms of how we are all tasked to engage technology, in my opinion, we have only just begun to figure out how we will work together to preserve our histories and cultural heritage. Today, we emphasize digital history archives, development and management, And this is a critical liberal arts institutional feature. The area of digital history that encompasses public and oral history is also key to this development, and I'm also thinking about the work of one of my colleagues, Dr. Lewis Moon. We need to determine clearly what kind of repositories, archives, and databases do we want and need. We need to assess why they are important now, how they would be important in the future, and then we need to begin making them. At some point, we need digital historians who are also programmers and those who can improve our history-based internet search engines. Now, I say this because many of my students are involved with programming, and of course, the younger children are involved with programming. So I decided over the summer to try to learn programming. So I started with the very, very lowest levels, and it took about 4 weeks for me to stare at the screen and actually understand what I was looking at. And at that moment, I jumped up out of my seat. I was so happy. I understand code, or at least that particular code. So this is a very, very exciting time for learning. So in conclusion, as historians in the digital revolution are on a quest for immortality, we should join them. But they're not on this quest so that individuals can be remembered forever, but so that societies, peoples, cultures, events, and issues can be assessed, recalled, and studied in the future. We have this opportunity to be participants and observers in this digital history revolution and experience how this has and will continue to transform academic communication. We know that history as a discipline will also continue to change, and the question will remain prescient. How do humans interact with historical information and technology? So philosophically speaking, the study of history is about memory, recollection, and understanding. We seek wider, greater access to historical information and newer venues for the dissemination of online history scholarship. Most of all, we want to communicate in ways that help us all define tomorrow. Thank you very much.